Hallo iedereen, welkom bij Dutch & Go. Today we're going to be talking about false friends. This is a series. I'm going to be doing a couple of videos about false friends. Today is about false friends between Dutch and English. If you're not familiar with the concept of false friends basically are words that are related or are very similar in both languages but have radically different meanings or implications or don't exist at all. But you might think that they exist. Something like that. So basically, that's false friends. Words that you think, oh yeah, I know that word. I can use it. And then you can't. And then they're like, ha ha ha, we're evil. Yes. Yes. Let's go. So I have a list here of 10 words or phrases or things that I want to go over with you. And the first one is the word fijn. Fijn in Dutch means nice, great. So you can't use it in the same way that you would use fine in English. Fine in English, you can use this as a reaction. How was your weekend? That's fine. It's kind of okay. In Dutch, no. If you say, hoe was your weekend? Het was fijn. That means, het was leuk. Het was heel leuk. It's explicitly positive. So just be aware of that. If you want to be all passive aggressive on people, and if people ask you, how are you? Fine. Yeah, and then in Dutch, that doesn't work. Hoe gaat het met je? Fijn. You can't use it like that, because it just means fun, nice, cool, great, that kind of thing. It's explicitly positive, and you can't use it as a reaction to the question, hoe gaat het met je? Alles oké, okay, alles prima, goed, maar niet fijn. Nah. Valse vriend, nummer 2. Ik ben goed. This is a very common one. So you can't use ik ben goed as an answer to the question hoe gaat het met je? It just basically means I'm great. As in, I'm the best. It's I mean, unless you're Donald Trump. Donald, are you watching? You might be. But the point is, you can't use that because it sounds arrogant. I know people won't immediately think that if they ask you, hoe gaat het met je? En jij zegt, ik ben goed. That automatically means that you are arrogant. But that's just kind of what it implies. If you use ik ben in combination with any adjective, it is a certain estimation of either how you are feeling right now. Ik ben ziek, ik ben moe. Or how you are as a person. Ik ben sympathiek, ik ben open, ik ben sociaal, ik ben introvert, ik ben kalm, ik ben nerveus, ik ben gestresseerd, etc. So just be careful, don't use ik ben goed as a reaction to hoe gaat het met je. Just say, goed. Or if you want to be all fancy and all and impress your teacher, you can also say, met mij gaat het goed en met jou. But really, nobody speaks like that unless it's a textbook. And, you know, generally people who write textbooks tend to not really have an idea of how people actually speak. Fascinating, huh? Example number 3, or false friend number 3 rather, is klaar. Oh, horrible, horrible false friend. So, klaar in Dutch means ready. It only means ready and it doesn't mean clear. So, for example, I can say, hey, mijn project is klaar. Or, for example, ik ben klaar. De soep is klaar. We kunnen eten. It just means ready. However, if you want to use it like, if you want to use clear in Dutch, you have to say, dat is duidelijk, dat is helder. Niet dat is klaar. That doesn't make any sense. However, there's still like an expression, klaar water. There are certain like specific phrases that still mean sort of transparent or like clear, but it's not common at all and it's very specific old expressions, you know, that as a student I wouldn't be bothering if because it's only going to confuse you more. Only thing that you need to know is klaar means something different than clear. If you want to say clear in Dutch, just say duidelijk or helder. Duidelijk? Duidelijk. Valse vriend nummer 4, wachten, verwachten. Okay, this one is not so much a false friend as it's just more like a be careful. Because in English, of course, if you want to say wachten, so to wait means wachten. Wachten is most commonly used with the preposition op. So ik wacht, like that you can use. Or if you wait for someone, for something, ik wacht op iemand, ik wacht op iets, ik wacht op een brief, ik wacht op een document, etc. If you want to use to expect, then be careful, don't use wachten, use verwachten. So, ik verwacht dat hij morgen terug zal zijn. I expect that he'll be back tomorrow. Just be careful. They're both very similar words, but they mean radically different things. Wachten means to wait, and verwachten, to expect. Also, for example, if you want to use the phrase in verwachting zijn, then it means you're expecting. You're expecting a baby. You are pregnant. Ik ben in verwachting. That's it. And then you also have, of course, the noun de verwachting, which is the expectation. De verwachtingen zijn dat we in het eerste kwartaal veel winst zullen maken. That's it. False friend number 5. Bezig en druk. Oh boy. Here we go. Bezig, literally, I mean, you might think, oh yeah, bezig, I know that. That means busy. Schmushme, more or less. Bezig is when you're doing something right now. So for example, sorry, ik kan nu niet praten, ik ben bezig. And you don't want to specify what you're doing right now, you're just, I'm busy doing something right now. However, on the other hand, druk is when you're generally busy. When you're, for example, in a busy phase in your life, or you have a busy week or a busy day. For example, ik heb een drukke dag, ik heb een drukke week. Or, generally speaking, ik heb het druk. I know that's weird. I also don't know why the het is there. But basically, if you want to say, I'm busy, just generally, I'm occupied, I have a lot of things to do, I have a lot of things going on right now, ik heb het druk. And that's how you would say that. Does that make sense? I really hope it does. So be careful. Bezig kind of means busy, but not completely. So just be careful. The next one is also like, it's kind of a false friend, a little bit, and something to be careful about. It's the difference between allemaal and alle. So, first of all, alle is almost always combined with a noun. So, alle mensen moeten hier wachten. Alle dieren in het bos gaan naar een ander bos, want hun bos is afgebrand. Geen idee. Beetje pessimistisch, beetje donker. Maar ja, dat. Hè? Alle plus noun. However, allemaal qualifies the subject. So, allemaal says something about your subject. And it's always a subject in plural. And allemaal appears after the verb. And it means that all of the people in the subject. So, for example, wij gaan allemaal naar huis. De dieren gaan allemaal naar een ander bos. Wij wonen allemaal in dit appartement. Etc. So that would be all of us. All of the animals, etc. So, yeah, just be careful. There's some overlap here with English, but not completely. So there's a difference between allemaal and alle, and there's also a radical difference in how you would use them. I hope that that's clear. Next false friend. Zullen en willen. Okay, this is one for, you know, A1 students, but still, it's something to be aware about, you know, to know about. Willen in Dutch means to want, and you can use that for desires. Ik wil een kopje koffie drinken. Ik wil naar huis gaan. Zij wil een nieuwe auto kopen. And zullen is only used for the future. It's only used for plans, promises, etc. And it means to will in English, or sometimes also to shall, depending on context. But for example, ik zal jou helpen, dat beloof ik. Zij zal vanavond om 8 uur naar huis komen. En wij zullen dit weekend een mooie wandeling maken. That's it. That's a plan, promise, etc. So that's the difference between zullen and willen. Basic, but important, and hopefully useful. False friend number 8. Eventueel en uiteindelijk. So, eventueel, eventually, in English, they don't mean the same thing. Eventueel means maybe. Eventueel kunnen we dit proberen, maar ik weet niet of dat zal helpen. Eventueel zullen we dit weekend een fiets huren, maar misschien is dat een beetje te duur. So, Meaning it could be an option, but I'm not really completely considering it. It could be an option. That's kind of what eventueel means. However, if you want to say eventually in Dutch, you should use the word uiteindelijk. And uiteindelijk zijn ze allemaal ziek geworden. Eventually, they all got sick as a result. So, uiteindelijk would be eventually in English and niet eventueel. I hope that's clear. On to false friend number 9. Raar en zeldzaam. Raar in Dutch means strange, weird. Ik heb een vriend en hij is een beetje raar. Hij is 30 jaar en hij vangt nog altijd Pokémons in mijn tuin. Heel raar. Strange, weird. However, if you want to say rare in Dutch, then it would be zeldzaam. Bijvoorbeeld, kijk eens, ik heb hier een Pokémon gevangen en hij is heel zeldzaam. Daar. There you go. I'm young still. I know about Pokémons. I'm so cool. False friend number 10. Menen, bedoelen, betekenen. In case you're wondering, but note, I'm a rabid follower of your YouTube channel and I've already seen that video. Yes, that's why I'm doing a callback to this one. If you haven't seen that one and you want to understand how to use the verb to mean in English, in Dutch, then please check out my previous video about that because I think that that will be extremely helpful. And that's it. This is a short selection. These are just 10 words of very frequent false friends. Let me know in the comment section if you enjoyed this and if you thought this was helpful and maybe I can make some more, who knows? I've also included some links to other websites that also have some more false friends between Dutch and English that you can use to lavish yourself upon and revel in and, you know, get a migraine from. I hope this video was helpful. Thank you so much for watching and tot de volgende keer bij Dutch and Go. Dag!